1, 2, 3 easy tips on how to build a website for free. In this video, I'll share with you how to create a website without paying a dime. That's right, totally free. More about it coming up. What's up, guys and girls? I'm Marian, and my passion is to create the web and help you be part of it. If you're new over here, this is CodeTap, where you'll master how to build websites, how to create a website from scratch with or without any knowledge of coding. So consider subscribing. If you appreciate me, make sure to drop a like for this video, as I would really be grateful for that. This setup needs nodejs and gulp to run properly. If you haven't got those ones, check the required tools playlist in the link above or in the description below and get it done. Before we start with our three steps, let's have a look at our final project website that we're about to build. Okay guys, so on the left side we've got our W3 Schools replica, and on the right side we have w3schools.com, the real website. We've created a similar top navigation menu, the left navigation menu, and the center of it, which is the content. I've changed a bit the footer, as it's a more commonly used scenario which will benefit you in the long run. We can also navigate through this to secondary landing pages, and then one more level deep down. That's it. Now let's go to our three steps. We want to open our console, our terminal, cmd on Windows, and let's create a directory using the mkdir command, mkdir, and the name of the directory, I'll name it cool stuff, and hit enter. Then we want to change into this cool stuff directory. We're using cd space cool stuff. Once I type enough letters, I can press tab until I get the right directory and hit enter. In this cool stuff directory, we'll put all our future projects. So let's start with our first step. Let's go back to our browser and navigate to github.com. I'll bump this up using Control Plus a few times. Let's go on your profile and choose stars. Over here, look for pug-starter and click on it. If you haven't got pug-starter to your favorites, this is the address where you can find it. And once you're on the landing page, you can use the star button to add it to your favorites, so it will be easily and quickly accessible later on. The next step is to go and click on this green button, the clone or download, followed by copy to clipboard. Once we got this text copied, let's switch back to our command line and do the first step, which is make a copy of this repository on my computer from GitHub. Git clone, let's paste the path and then hit space and give it a name. I'll name it w3schools-replica. Now let's change into our new directory. Using dir, we can see that git created for us w3schools-replica. So let's say change directory space w3 and let's press tab and hit enter. Over here, if we say dir on Linux and Mac, it's ls space hyphen lah to do the same as dir. So we can see that we have a bunch of files over here, and if we say git status, git will give us a message which means it's tracking this repository. If we say git remote hyphen v, we can see that this project is still linked to Marian's burlea slash pug starter. So we want to unlink it from there and link it to our personal project. In every project, Git keeps its files in a .git folder, so we want to remove that at the moment. So on Linux or Mac, we'll say rm space hyphen rf .git, which will remove the Git folder. On Windows, we'll say rd space slash s space slash q space .git, which will do exactly the same. So once we remove the Git folder, if we say git status, we get a fatal error, which means Git no longer tracks this project. Now let's fix that and go back to GitHub and click this plus icon next to your profile and choose new repository. You should leave as owner your own username. I'll choose codetap.io and then I'll say w3schools replica. The description is optional, feel free to fill in one. I'll go and hit this button, create repository. And let's pay attention to this part over here with these six lines. This echo here will create a readme.md file with these contents in it. This is necessary as when you want to initialize a Git project, you need minimum one file in that project. However, if we say dir or ls space hyphen lah on Linux or Mac, we can see that we got a bunch of files and folders, so that's not the case for us. We'll skip this line over here and go straight to git init. Let's copy it and paste it in our command line and hit enter. Now Git has initialized a new repository in this folder. If we say git status, we no longer get a fatal error. Now we also want to remove the source folder, as no examples file are needed because we'll start from scratch. So to do that on Linux and Mac, we is rm minus rf src, and on Windows is rd space slash s space slash q src. Now let's go to the next one, which is git add. And instead of adding the readme file, we want to add everything. So when we say git space add space dot, it means add the current directory and everything in it so Git can track it. When we say git status, we can see that the files have gone from red to green, which means Git has started to track them. Now let's save those changes with a message. You can go for the default one. However, I will recommend you to be a bit more creative. This is my first save in Git, which is called a commit. Okay. The next two lines don't need any change, so let's just copy paste them and hit enter. Give it a sec. Once it's done, if we refresh this page over here, we can see that our repository is synced from local to GitHub. Over here, there is also a commit link, says one commit. If you click on it, we can see our save with a commit message. Okay, our next step is to tell Node Package Manager to install dependencies. So let's do that, npm space I. Once the install is finished, we can close this one and let's open a new Visual Studio Code window and add our project to it. Let's add w3schools replica. And over here, let's recreate our source folder. So we'll name it src by clicking the new folder icon. And in this src folder, let's create an index.pug file. So index.pug. In this file, let's do a very basic minimal HTML template. So doc type HTML, then we follow it by HTML and head and body. In pug, it's very important to pay attention to spacing, as everything needs to be indented properly so children and parents can know which one is which. So over here, let's say in the head, the title, this is my first pug file, and the title h1, hello from pug. Let's save this and let's go for the menu help and keyboard shortcut reference. Let's bump this a bit. Let's look for terminal. So over here you have some shortcuts. Just find the correct one for your operating system. For Windows is Control and single quote to toggle the command line or the terminal. So if I say Control and single quote, it will toggle the command line. On Mac, it's some Alt and nearby key. I forgot which one it is. Anyway, once we've got the command line opened, our first step is to say npm start. And it will open the browser with our HTML page. Let's split the screen for a moment and play a bit with it. Okay, so this should look fine. Now, every time we save this index.pug file, gulp will watch the pug files being saved and compile it in the temporary folder into its correspondent index.html. So let's open both of those ones. I'll click the split window button over here, and then I'll go on the left side and choose to split them horizontally. So I'll have the index file, index.pug file over here, and the index.html file over here opened. Once I make any change over here, watch what happens. So I make a change and then save it. When I save it, this dot will disappear over here and it will convert into a close. Once I save this file, gulp compiled pug into HTML, the HTML file has been updated and at the same time the browser has been refreshed. Let's do it one more time. This time I'll choose file and save. Once I click save, watch over here what happens, and then over here, and then over here. So file, save. See? The index.pug has been converted into HTML by the gulp process that watched that file, and also the browser has been refreshed. You'd be quick to notice that in pug we no longer have to have opening and closing brackets and opening and closing tags. You just type the tag name followed by a space and then the contents of it. More about pug coming up. And if you want to skip ahead and become more comfortable with pug, just go and Google pug language. Then head on over to pug.js.org and read a bit of the documentation over here. You can find more examples on what you would write in pug and what you'd get in HTML. So this is the end of part one, where we've discovered how to start a website from scratch for free in three easy steps. In part two, we'll create our landing page and style it.
Make sure to follow CodeTap on YouTube and Facebook. Other two resources that I really recommend are W3 Schools, where you can literally start from scratch and discover more about HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and so many more. Another one that goes hand in hand with W3 Schools is Free Code Camp, where you can put in practice your new skills and test them. You can go on Facebook and search Free Code Camp and join the worldwide community or one that's closer to you. I really like the challenges on Free Code Camp, as they will prepare you and are really close to future real-world client requirements. Thanks for watching this video. You've been really amazing. One of the most powerful tools to help you understand the world of coding is to leverage the power of a community. And you can do that by leaving comments. So go on and leave a comment below right now. Be as descriptive as possible, as help is on the way. I promise that I'll do my best to answer each and every one of your comments. Now show me some real love and give me the thumbs up if you like this video, or thumbs down if you didn't. Subscribe now if you haven't done so to skyrocket your web developer career. I'll see you in the next lesson, and as always, create something awesome.